Thank you, Mr. Speaker and members. I rise today to allow the voters of California to make a decision on ACA 6. But I want to talk about an individual and not people or they or them. I want to talk again about someone I know, somebody who I lost this year, my brother Billy. And sometimes I talk about Billy's story. And as some of you know, he died less than a year ago, October. And he is one of these individuals who had gone in and out of county jail and even prison. And when he would come out, I often would ask him, what do you want to do? And he would talk about, I want to go back to school. I want to get a job. I want to do something. And he was 50, and he said, I have a lot of life to give. I want to do something. And yet so often the barriers that came in front of him, whether it was getting to a probation appointment, whether it was his addiction with alcohol, whether it was the voices he heard from mental health issues, from coming in and out of being on the streets, he didn't make it. But his story is so many stories here. It's the story, as we said, of families, of those who struggle. And when we see those who struggle that are released, many times we all want them to improve, and yet some backstep. A few years ago, I went to Chino Prison to not only the lower security, but the maximum security. And I walked through those grounds, and I watched. And again, those stories, some of the prison guards told me directly, we have to do better, because the people coming out of these prisons are going to be your neighbors. So it's up to us to try to make sure that we can prepare while they are in prison, but also when they are released, to integrate back into society in a way that makes a difference. And voting is a way that allows them to have some type of hope. So with that, I ask for your support on ACA 6.
Thank you, Ms. Quirk Silva.